Hello, and welcome back to Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord. I'm your host, Barbaca, and, I'm by Makeb. I saw an army pretty much break apart right here at Tep's Castle. I'm going to try and take Makeb, which has almost 700 defenders, but I've counted all these. I have roughly 900 or so in here. And they're all very close by. Most broke off from the army there. So, let's do this. Siege the town. I will build. Siege tower. That. They're really gathering, aren't they? Oh, there's a big army down there. We should leave. Shall I break up the army? I can't face that with these ones around me. Okay, we outnumber the enemy. Good. Your liege is not worthy of you. Join Ragnvard. Okay. Monshug is not known for keeping his word. The interests of the good of the realm first. I have a strategy to win, and my strategy is working. Better to die fighting. No. All right, we'll fight you to the end. Let's attack, and then break up the army immediately after this. We number them by 200, and I have some decent troops with me. Some of my previous battles I've lost because I've had recruits and medium strength troops mostly.
Chance!
archers right there. Cut through them. They're leading us to us to their spawn position.
Infantry from hell! Infantry forward! Soldier! Forward!
We're not killing as many as I would have liked.
Everyone!
We'll fall back to our spawn position. No, no, should not be in there. No! Damn it. Alright, I suppose we'll watch the slaughter from here. We have more soldiers. Hopefully that will carry the day. And if not, oh well. Okay, we might be killing more of them than they are of us. This mad charge. they seem to be getting the better of us? Or... No, it's roughly equal. The number of casualties on both sides. It goes up and down for either side, but it looks as though we'll have our victory through sheer strength of numbers. They've probably taken out more of us than we have of them. I'm not the best commander. I really should give command to someone else, or maybe only have command of the archers or something. But I've taken out a few. Not many. I'll be lucky if I killed a dozen. Okay. We've lost 500 soldiers. More or less. Wait, no, that's the attacker army. We lost 200. Roughly 400, that's half our army. Okay, that's not bad. We've taken out more of them. And done. I'll upgrade some of my troops. Take some of these prisoners. Probably need more horsemen. I still have 110 that can fight. Fighting those bandits over there. Good. Okay. We'll break up the army now. Anyway, I'll cut away here and come back a bit later. See you then. Okay, we are back. I've always... Whenever a... notable person from a village has asked me to get access to some field or something. I've always given it to a companion to do. It's probably a short mission, but I'm going to do it myself this time because, well, I want to try it. Also, our war with the Khuzait ended. I was traveling through Sturgian lands and... well, they made peace, and the Aserai made war again, so we're fighting them now.
My friend, it's been a while. So then, what is it?
I heard you need help with a problem.
I have a bit of a dispute with Scorin. I recently purchased the right to graze cattle in the nearby pastures from a landowner there. But now some of the villagers are making problems.
What's the problem?
They claim I don't have the right to graze there. that village land can't be bought and sold like that. But look, I spent my silver. I won't get it back. Meanwhile, I can't afford to wait. I need someone to ride along with my herders and my cattle, and so my cattle can graze. One way or the other, even if it means violence, I can't let my herd just starve. Is there any other way? You or one of your companions with some 5 men should do the job. Either way, I am willing to pay 1,200 dinars. I doubt they'll stand up long to real warriors. I can get your herdsmen to the pastures. I appreciate it. I wait for the good news.
Okay, I've never done this mission before, you know, personally, so let's see how this goes. I will leave. Landowner's pasture. A rural landowner has told you about his problem with the villagers of Skorin. Apparently he purchased the right to use the nearby pasture, but the villagers refused to clear out their flocks and threatened his herders. He asked you to clear the pasture so the herders can graze the flocks in peace. You agreed to do this job, so Skorin. Okay, done. So I need to go down there and do that. Oh.
Don't get involved in this. We've grazed our herds on these hillsides since our father's time. We don't care if one rich bastard gave a couple of bags of silver to another rich bastard. We don't care about title deeds or courts of law or any of that. Custom is custom, and we're not going anywhere.
Calm down your rights. No one has the right to sell your ancestral lands. These herdsmen can take their cattle elsewhere.
You can take your grievances to your lord or to whoever sold the land. The law says a buyer has rights, and you need to clear out.
You're just a rich bastard lackey.
Ah, so I encountered them. I suppose if I had a larger force, they might actually... If I had a smaller force, they might actually attack me if I had only 10 men or something. The Batanians really ate into us in the last war with them. We had this territory up here. Oh, an interesting I found lately is that I can create parties from my companions. I have Samar the Hyena I just created. I can also tell him to join my army without spending any influence. And if I really need troops, I can take troops from his party and he'll just go around and collect others. So that's interesting. Train troops. I suppose I can do that. Though I am at war. I should probably prepare for it. Good price for linen. Suppose I sell the rest in Epicatea or something. Anyway, I'll cut away here and come back a bit later. See you then. Okay, not long after we were up here, I moved down here, which is under siege by this Aserai army. They're attacking this castle, and I'm going to try and save it, if I can. If not, oh well. With the garrison and the army in the field, I think we have a chance. Break in to help the defenders. Okay, we lost 76. Help the castle, and we'll fight. Okay, let's hope we can win. That I didn't make a huge mistake. Come on, hurry it up. I've never fought in a siege defense before. This will be a learning experience. Begin. I'll follow the archer. He knows where he's going. I do not. Perhaps I can increase my skill with siege equipment, maybe. Damaging it quite a bit with my blunt arrows. So, where do I get more arrows? Right here? There we go.
break it. I hope we can. Such a just aim for them. Going down the ladder. Why are they doing that? Will they breach the gate? Looks as though they have. Seem to be killing more of the enemy than they are of us. Keep aiming too high. Oh, I hope my game doesn't crash. Damn it. We need to move. I need to move. I need to run. Sturgia. Coming. Damn it. Oh, I just seem to keep running. Human, what are you waiting for? The enemy's at the gates. I'm lagging so badly right now. It looks as though we're winning. That's good. Where is the enemy? Well, we managed to hold them off. I do very much apologize for the lag, my lack of talking. I've been trying to focus on not dying. Nope. I need to do something with my computer. Make it better or change some settings, I don't know. How many did I take out? Ooh, 21. Not bad. You're my prisoner now. You're my prisoner. So many prisoners. Can I take them all? I'll just throw them inside this castle here. Ooh, that's a better cloak than I have. Or shoulder pads, I suppose. I'll go through the loot later. Anyway, that's our first siege defense. I do hope you guys have enjoyed it. Please like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you next time. See you then.